Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemi. This is Mridul and I'm part of the instructor team at MakerDemi. In this video, we will understand the functionality and features of the Arduino IoT Cloud. Before that, let us first understand what an Arduino is. Arduino is a hardware and software based open source electronics platform. The Arduino software and boards are easy to use for beginners, yet flexible enough for advanced users. In today's world, IoT is one of the most important technologies of everyday life. Furthermore, to make IoT connectivity easier, Arduino has built a cloud application called Arduino IoT Cloud. Arduino IoT Cloud is a cloud application that helps makers build connected objects in a quick, easy, and secure way. The Arduino IoT Cloud provides easy connectivity through the web application. It also provides remote mobile applications on Google Play Store and Apple Store for quickly connecting and monitoring your IoT devices from anywhere in the world. Arduino IoT Cloud uses the industry's best practices without users having to worry about the details. All IoT device communications to the cloud also use industry standard SSL protocol for encryption. Now let us look at the working of the Arduino IoT Cloud. First, the board associated with the thing updates the values in its memory as the changes occur. Then, the thing senses the change of the variables and interacts with the world. Later, the data is sent and received as an event change through the IoT cloud. Finally, the thing manages the variables and displays the values on the dashboard or mobile apps as assigned. Which devices can be connected to the Arduino IoT cloud? All the Arduino manufactured devices that can be connected to the cloud are compatible with the Arduino IoT cloud. These devices include MKR Wi-Fi 1010, MKR 1000 Wi-Fi, MKR WAN 1300, MKR WAN 1310, MKR GSM 1400, MKR NB 1500, Nano 33 IoT, Nano RP 2040 Connect, and Portenda H7. Apart from the Arduino manufactured boards, Arduino IoT Cloud also supports third-party devices such as the ESP8266, the ESP32, and LoRaWAN modules. Arduino has provided the users with 4 monthly or yearly plans for the Arduino Cloud accessibility. These plans include the following: Free Plan, Entry Plan, Maker Plan, Maker Plus Plan. For most beginner-level applications or for learning, the free plan is more than enough. However, if you are a seasoned maker or want to explore the full features offered by the platform, please check out the other plans too. You can pause the screen now to look at the plan comparison table or visit the link given in the video description. Let us now have a look at some of the advantages and limitations of Arduino IoT Cloud. The few advantages of Arduino IoT Cloud are as follows. Automatically generated code. This feature adapts the code with minimal effort, removing barriers for those unfamiliar with coding and empowering makers of all ages and experiences. Easy onboarding. Cloud automatically generates a sketch layout when setting up a new device, so anyone can edit it right away and quickly go from unboxing to building the project. On-the-go mobile dashboard. This feature allows access to check data and remote sensor monitoring from anywhere using accessible widgets from mobile phones. Arduino Create Agent Debugger. For connecting a board to the Arduino IoT Cloud, one must install the Arduino Create Agent plugin. Through this plugin, we can easily debug our connections by opening the debug console. A few limitations of Arduino IoT Cloud are as follows. Variable limit. For beginners, if there is a project requiring monitoring of more than 5 variables, they have to buy at least the entry plan to monitor all the desired variables properly. High compilation time. The Arduino IoT Cloud platform's compiler takes a lot more time to compile than Arduino's offline IDE. Sketch Debugger. Unlike Arduino IDE version 2.0, the Arduino IoT Cloud does not have a sketch debugger, making it tough to debug the code. Library development. Users cannot modify or include any custom-made libraries other than the libraries officially provided by Arduino. The Arduino IoT Cloud can be configured in a few simple steps. The steps of getting started with the Arduino IoT Cloud are 1. Creating an Arduino IoT Cloud account. 2. Creating a thing. 3. Configuring a device. 4. Associating a device for the thing. 5. Creating variables for the sketch. 6. Providing the network credentials. 7. Editing the sketch. And 8. Customizing the dashboard using widgets. We will cover an actual implementation of Arduino IoT Cloud with the Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect board in the next Learn Technology in 5 Minutes video. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.